Hello everyone, today we'll be climbing Moel Famau and it's going to be hub drive versus midrive. The hub drive is a Bafang GO6 running at 45 amps peak. The midrive is a Bafang bbshd running at 30 amps peak. It's always good to zigzag. It should become clear which is the best climber. I don't think there's going to be a lot in it. My friend's a lot fitter than me. Let's see how it goes. Moel Famau! That's the hub drive, cruising up it no problem at all. And at real speed, you see I do slightly catch him up on the hill.
Yeah.
The first of two punches.
Make it up there, Bri, or what?
The fat tires actually don't work very well over this kind of ground. They keep riding through the ruts, quite difficult, not ideal. Okay, here we go, the big climb starts. Now this is where the mid-drive comes into its own. The hub drive starts to stall on really steep ground, and even though he's pushing 45 amps into that back motor and destroying his battery, I can still reel him in.
Oh, I want to go on there.
This is a killer. Bottom gear, hard as I can go. It's either going to wheelie over the back or spin the back wheel. That couple you can see, couldn't believe I was making it up here. The biggest problem actually is the front end is so light you can't steer it through the ruts, so the bike just goes where it wants to. Quite difficult. As you can see, for most of this climb, the hub drive does perfectly well, and it's so much nicer on your ears. This is the Jubilee Town, which was built to commemorate the Golden Jubilee of George III in 1810, the Mad King that lost America. My friend always chooses practicality over aesthetics. The tower was never completed because they ran out of funds, which just goes to show how popular he was. And then it fell down in 1862, so this is what's left of it.
Yes, they did.
The rangers had a moan, and then an argument ensued about the status of the path. It's only 1200 years old, so you'd think we'd have sorted it by now. £120 worth of Chinese forks. Do you trust them? I honestly think overall the advantages of an hub drive outweigh the disadvantages. It's a pretty good setup.
You're going to fly it to the tower? It's going to end in tears. Bye bye, little drone.
Meters, 125 meters high.
I think I can hear it. Oh, yeah, see it, yep. Oh yeah, it is high up, isn't it?
He's so relieved it's made its way back, he's showing off now.
Beautiful today. Hey, hey. Run it down. us why you had to hide away for so long. Why did we go wrong?
I'm shouting him. He's gone the wrong way. He's only got one bar left. It's hilarious. Chain keeps popping off. What the problem is my three wheeler's jammed solid. So when I stop pedaling, yeah, great stuff. So which one would you choose, the hub drive or the mid drive? The mid drive rips through chains and sprockets. The hub drive can't quite climb as well. Uses a bit more power, you need a bigger battery. You haven't got the ultimate range. But on a day like this, I find the hub drive perfectly alright. And it's just a lovely bike to ride. With all that constant power, you just have to help it on the steep bits. The other disadvantage for the hub drive is you're severely overclocking it. It's only a 750 watt rated motor and you're pushing through about 2,500 watts at peak. But as long as you're sensible, you don't push it too hard, you'll be fine. Scared the sheep. You scared the sheep.
I'll remember you this way. Stop the skies. Tell us why you had to hide away for so long.
Drone has crashed. Search and rescue.